Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In this video, we're going to look at signal detection theory. So in the last video, we talked about psychophysics. We talked about these ideas of thresholds. So we had the absolute threshold, which was the minimum amount of stimulation that's needed for us to detect a stimulus. And then we talked about the just noticeable difference, or the difference threshold. And this was the amount of change that's necessary in a stimulus in order for us to detect that a change has occurred. So one of the problems that we have in both of these situations is a problem of noise. So what do we mean by noise? Well, a noise is anything that can interfere with our detection of a stimulus. So it's not specific to hearing. It's anything that interferes. So we use this term noise to refer to anything that interferes with detection. And what you'll realize is that noise is everywhere for all of our senses, right? The world is noisy, right? If you think about trying to measure your absolute threshold for hearing, right? You can imagine that I want to find the quietest sound that you can hear. Well, I'm going to have other noise that gets in the way. And even if I put you in a soundproof room, we're still going to have a problem of noise, right? Because there's no such thing as a perfectly quiet environment. As soon as you get into that quiet room, you're going to realize that, well, there's air in the room and there's air molecules moving around, and some of those are going to hit your eardrums. That's maybe interfering with your ability to hear the noise. Or you're going to realize that maybe there's some ringing in your ears that you don't always notice, but you notice it now that you're in a quiet room. Or you become aware of your heart beating, blood moving in your body, right? That might interfere with your ability to hear, right? If your heart beats at the same moment as the sound that I'm playing, that you're trying to detect, it might cover the sound up. You might not be able to hear it anymore. Or depending on how you breathe, right? Your breathing is going to make noise, right? So all of these things are going to interfere with your ability to detect a stimulus. And this is why trying to find absolute thresholds is actually really difficult. And there's all different types of noise that can interfere. For vision, for instance, I could put you in a perfectly dark room, but you actually still have some things that you're going to see, right? You've probably experienced this. If you're in total darkness, it's not just pure blackness that you see. You know, you see sort of little bits of light, and there's spontaneous neurons firing in your brain, and you're sort of almost hallucinating these little things that you think you're seeing. And that's going to interfere with your ability to detect light that's actually in the room. So we have this problem of noise. And we can look at, in signal detection theory, what we look at is the possible outcomes, right? So we have your response, which is, if we use the hearing example. So let's say you put on some headphones, you're in a quiet room, and I play a sound, and you either tell me, yes, you can hear the sound, or no, you don't hear anything. So those are your two responses, right? We'll say you have to answer yes or no. Okay. Well, there's also two possibilities on the side of the signal, right? Is there a signal? Yes or no. Maybe I didn't play a sound, right? So over here we have the presence of a signal, yes or no, and we have your response. Yes, I hear it. No, I don't. And this gives us this matrix of four possible outcomes. So the first possible outcome is I play the sound and you say, I heard that. Well, we call that a hit. Another thing that's possible is I play the sound, but you don't say that you heard it. And that would be a miss, right? There's a signal present, but you don't detect it. The other thing that could happen is I don't play a sound and you say, I heard that. But there actually wasn't a sound that you were supposed to hear. So in this case, we call that a false alarm. Right? Or if you take a statistics course, you may see this type of error called a type 1 error. Right? This idea that there is a signal, there is not a signal, and you think that there is. That's a type 1 error. Now, there's also the possibility that there's no signal, and you don't say that you hear it. So I don't play a sound, and you say, I didn't hear anything. And that would be a correct rejection. All right, so we have sort of these two possible errors here. So the false alarm, which I mentioned is sometimes called a type 1 error, and then the miss here, where there is a signal, but you don't detect it. And this is sometimes, you'll see this referred to as a type 2 error. And then you have these two sort of correct outcomes, where you have a hit, where there is a signal, and you detect it, or a correct rejection, where there is no signal, and you don't think that there's a signal. Okay, so we can imagine this sort of hearing test here, and these are the four possible outcomes, but you might realize, well, sometimes it's really easy to decide if I should say yes, right? I definitely heard that, or I definitely didn't hear anything. But there's a lot of cases, because we're trying to find this minimum stimulation, right? So it's going to be really hard to decide if you heard it or not, right? Because also we have this problem of noise. So a lot of times you're going to be sort of in the middle. And the real question here is, well, do you lean towards saying yes or do you lean towards saying no? And this is what's known as your, this is what's known as your response criteria. So your response criteria is essentially asking, what do you do when you're unsure? Do you lean towards yes or do you lean towards no? All right, so if we say you have a liberal response criteria, that means you lean towards saying yes, right? So you think you heard it, so you say, yeah, I heard that. Or we can say you have a more conservative response criteria, and that means when you're unsure, you lean towards no, right? You want to be really certain that you heard it, so if you're uncertain, you say no. And so now we can think about how this is going to influence your overall pattern of responding. Right, so you can imagine two people. You could imagine that I take this test and you take this test. We can imagine that we have exactly the same ears, right? That the stimulation, our ears are working equally well. They're identical, right? But if we have different response criteria, if I lean towards saying yes when I'm unsure and you lean towards saying no when you're unsure, our answers are going to end up being totally different, even though our stimulation is identical, even though our ears are working exactly the same way, right? So this is a big problem in signal detection theories. We have this question of, well, how liberal or conservative should our response criteria be? Right? The same ears could give us different answers, and we might have to think about, well, which of these errors is going to be worse? Right? Do I want more false alarms? If I lean towards yes, I'm going to get all the hits, but I'm going to have more false alarms. If I lean towards no, I'm going to have more correct rejections, but I'm also going to have more misses. And I might have to think about which of those is better. And this brings us to applications of signal detection theory, right? So it's not just for absolute thresholds or just noticeable differences. What I hope you realize is that signal detection theory applies to almost every area of your life, because there's a lot of decisions you have to make, and very often you don't know, should I say yes, should I say no? It's unclear what the correct answer is. The truth is that life is noisy, right? Most of the signals we're trying to detect are hard to detect, and there's a lot of things that interfere, right? So this can be things like wondering, you know, a police officer wondering if somebody's reaching for their wallet or for a weapon. This is a life-altering decision that you might have to make, right? And you have to think about which type of error is better or worse, right? Or if you're on a jury and you're thinking about, you know, is this person guilty or innocent? Well, is it worse for me to have an innocent person falsely imprisoned or a guilty person go free? Which type of error do I want to lean towards? Right? And so the same people given the same information could come to different conclusions. Right? You can imagine a doctor looking at the results of an exam, looking at a scan and wondering, is this noise in the data or is this a tumor? How liberal or conservative should I be? Should I recommend immediate preventative surgery or is that unnecessary? Or if I don't recommend it, if I lean towards saying it's probably nothing, it's probably noise, then 6 months later it turns out it was a tumor and now it's grown. You know, these are hard decisions that people have to make. You can think about other decisions. You know, when you think about which college you're going to choose, which college is right for you, right? It's hard to make that choice. Or in dating, you might think about finding the one, right? That you want to, the person you want to marry. Well, when it comes to dating, how liberal or conservative should you be on accepting that first date? I mean, on the one hand, if you're too conservative, if you always lean towards no, well, you'll correctly reject all those people that aren't right for you, but you might miss the person who would be really good. On the other hand, if you lean towards being too liberal and you say yes to every first date, I mean, you're more likely to find that one person to get that hit, that person who's right for you, but in the meantime, you're going to have a lot of false alarms. You're going to go on a lot of dates that you're kind of wasting your time on, right? So hope you see that we can really apply signal detection theory to all sorts of decisions that we make. And I encourage you to think about all the different areas where signal detection theory can be applied to your own life. And think about, what's my response criteria? Which type of error is better or worse when I'm making this decision? Okay, so I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.